supplemental instruction series of videos for Chemistry 121. Today we're going to be talking about the mole.
Mole.
Yeah.
Cut it off, chop it up, make some guacamole.
Cut it up, make some guacamole!
That's right.
Awesome powers.
Yes.
You gotta do it. Mm-hmm. I'm Joey Smokey, by the way.
Yes, and today we're going to be discussing the mole.
Mole.
Alright. Now, what is the mole, you might ask?
Guacamole.
Yes, kind of. But a mole is essentially an amount, a unit of something. Like a dozen.
Avocados.
Yes. Or a mole of avocados, if you will.
To make some guacamole.
That's right. Now, the mole...
Mole.
...is a really big number. I mean, huge. It's represented by what's called Avogadro's number. And that number is 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd.
Avogadro's. Mm-hmm. Like avocados?
Kind of.
I like the references here.
Yes. So anyways, this is the number of units in one mole. And in case you don't think that's big enough, I'm going to write it out like this.
Wow.
I'm going to reach the board and I won't finish it.
Seriously?
Seriously. That's the number.
That's that.
Uh-huh.
And that's Avogadro's number.
Yes. This is why we use scientific notation.
So, if I wanted to have one mole of avocados, it would be that many avocados?
Yes, and it would most likely bury the entire surface of the Earth several times over.
With avocados?
Yes.
That's pretty amazing.
Yes, that is a really, really big number.
That'd be a lot of guacamole.
Mm-hmm. But with atoms, or molecules, it's, you know, the reason we don't see things, you know, stacked up to everywhere is because atoms are really, really, really small.
Yeah, so I guess it makes sense that we can have such a big number when we talk about something like
exactly.
that.
Exactly. So essentially, you know, you can say you have, like, a mole of, or hydrogen atoms.
Okay.
You know, if you have one mole.
Mole.
Yes, M-O-L is the abbreviation for mole.
Just drop the E off.
Yeah. Best abbreviation ever. So one mole.
Mole.
Of hydrogen atoms is equal to the Avogadro's number of atoms. Basically, like saying
wow.
A dozen eggs.
So one mole of hydrogen is going to have that many atoms inside of it.
Mm-hmm.
That's a lot.
That is a lot.
Wow. So what would we want to use the mole for then, as chemists?
Well, the mole is useful because it's useful in showing ratios in chemical reactions. Like, say we have this classic reaction. Good old forming water.
Ah, that's good. Water tastes good.
These coefficients, basically, meaning on our scale, I mean, usually this just means, you know, on the atomic scale, whatever, but
mm-hmm.
on the large scale, these coefficients represent moles.
Mole.
Ah.
So it's basically saying two moles
mole.
Of hydrogen gas and one mole,
mole.
Of oxygen gas form mm-hmm. two moles of water.
That's pretty cool.
And it's useful if you say you have a certain amount of hydrogen and you want to figure out how much water you can get by reacting it with, you know, excess amount of oxygen.
Okay, so
that's also useful. And it's also useful in determining, you know, if you have more of one than you need than the other.
Oh, that makes sense. So kind of be, you know, like make sure you have the proper ratio of things
yes,
in your
exactly.
reaction.
So essentially, you can use the moles for that because they're just a unit, you know. Two H2s and one O2 is going to be the same as two moles of H2 and one mole of O2, or two dozen H2s and one dozen O2.
Okay, so the mole is, when you think about it, it's kind of a little bit of an abstract unit.
Yes.
Okay.
Pretty much.
Yeah, because you can kind of make it represent different things.
Mm-hmm.
But in chemistry, it's basically to represent amount of something,
yes.
like a compound.
Yes, you can have a mole of pretty much everything.
Okay.
Atoms, molecules, avocados.
Guacamole.
Kittens.
Oranges.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Apples.
Apples. Grapefruit.
Possibilities are endless.
It is.
All right.
So that's the mole.
So that is the mole.
Mole.
That's essentially what it is.
I'm hungry for guacamole.
Yeah, I don't much care for it, but now that you mention it, salsa sounds good.
That's true.
Mm-hmm.
Guacamole and salsa go together.
Yep, they do.
Nacho time.
All right.